So hello guys, today we will be discussing Coursera Starter 21. The first starter of year 2022 has been over and now we will be absolving it. And there are three kinds of water sports one can enjoy: ABC and OK. ABC, OK. With at least once, OK. So the question states that let's say a person named as Devendra has initially Z rupees, OK, and he has already spent Y rupees. So we know that now he is having Z minus Y rupees, okay, and he wants to try A, B and C schools, okay. It is a common sense thing, okay, that when a person Devendra can try A, B, C, when he is having sufficient money, okay, it means that when Z minus 1 rupees is at least greater than or equal to sum of A plus B plus C. Okay, yeah. So we have to print yes. If Devendra will be able to, let's say, enjoy all the three sports after spending Y rupees out of total Z rupees, okay, and no in the other case, okay. So now we will be better understanding this problem while coding it, okay. So let's say submit practice. Shit, man. Let me write it. Hurry up, include. Actually, fits slash standard C++ is a header file that contains all of the required libraries that one needs in a computer programming. Okay, so here first you will be first you will ask user for number of test cases. Okay, now so the T represents number of test cases, and while T minus minus and while T minus minus, now we will further execute our code for each and test case. Okay, so now let's say verify. We will make a function verify which will verify whether Devendra will be able to enjoy all the sports or not. So now we need to define the function verify, and since we are required to print, so our function won't print and won't return anything. It will just print its value. Okay, now with every test case we need variable Z, Y, A, B and C. Very easy. Now we need to take input for these values, so Z, and do remember that we have input values in the same order as given in the question, okay, and otherwise in spite of correct logic our answer will be incorrect. Okay, so now we have value of Z, we have Y, A, B, C. And now I will try to explain you with the help of values. It says that let's say the person Devendra has initially 1000 rupees. For example, let's say Z equals to 1000 rupees. Okay, he has already spent some rupees Y. Let's say it's equals to 250. Okay, so now there is a sports with the price of A equals to 100. B equals to 200 and C equals to, let's say, 300. Okay, so now Devendra wants to now Coursera want us to decide whether Devendra will be able to enjoy all of these rides after spending Y rupees out of Z or not. Okay, so how will we check? We will check whether after spending Y rupees, it is after spending 250 rupees, he is having sufficient money or not. It means that 1000 minus 250, if it is let's say equal or greater than, okay, equal or greater than 100 plus 200 plus 300, if it is so, okay, then if it is so yes, else no. Okay, else no. So now let's see if it is equal. It means 1000 minus 250, left becomes, okay, so left hand side becomes 750. Okay, we want us to be equal or greater than 100 plus 300, then 600. Okay, so sum of ABC is 600. Okay, now we can see that 750 is clearly greater than 600. It means yes, it means Devendra will be able to enjoy all of the three rides. Okay, now consider a case when A equals to 250. B equals to 500, okay, and c equals to, let's say, 100. Now again, I keeping the values of y and z constant, okay, then sum of a plus b plus c will be like 250, okay, then it will be 250 plus 500 and plus 200, okay, let's do 200, c as 200 for easy calculation. So then it will be 950. While we know that after spending y rupees, out of z we have 750 as balance, okay. So, and we know that 750 is less than 900, okay. Or we can see that 750 greater equal than 900. This statement is false. Okay. Now I hope now it's clear. Okay. So now we have developed the logic that if z minus y is greater or equal than a plus b plus c, then we will say yes, Devendra can enjoy all of the three sports. Otherwise, no. Okay. So now we just coding this thing. Okay. Nothing much. See. If z minus y. Okay, is greater or equal than a plus b plus c, and now we will be just encapsulating it in parentheses. Okay, if yes, then it will print yes. Okay, then it will print yes. Else, it will print no. Okay, where is the question? Yeah, else it will say no. And now for every test case, in the last you will give a new line so that new test case prints its result in the new line. Okay, so now let me try this code with the help of test cases. Okay, so now we have printed our this test cases values, and now we will be running it. Okay, see, although I know that video is quite long, but since I want to make your logic clear, okay, like to help you how to think the logic, so that's why I'm explaining each and everything. Okay, so no yes, and like its output is also no yes. Okay, and we are getting no yes. Okay, it means it is same. Now we will try to submit it and we'll see if it passed all of the test cases, hidden test cases basically. Okay, and since like we are submitting in an online compiler on online judge, so it will take some time. Okay, so the result, yeah, we can see that it is passing all of the subtasks, that is all of the test cases. So here it is our correct. Okay, so see, it was a very easy problem.